Hi everyone, welcome to another video. Hope you're all doing well. So today I've got a really simple and effective method to get great looking city bases for your miniatures. Now, although we're using Legions Imperialis bases for this tutorial, this method will work absolutely fine for Warhammer 40,000 bases or even Stone Star bases for Age of Sigmar or the Old World. Now we're going to try and paint them up to match the recent Civitas road tiles that we saw released with Legions Imperialis, but as I said, this method could be used for 40k as well. So without further ado, let's get into it. So the first thing you need to do obviously is prime your bases. I've used Ghoul Grey by the Colour Forge, or alternatively you can use Grey Seer by Games Workshop. Next up, for any areas that we want to be darker on the bases, such as the road sections and the Aquilas, we're using Basilicarnum Grey contrast paint, and for those areas we're going to be using it straight out of the pot. So as usual with contrast paint, give it a good shake and then get a good amount on your brush and just spread it around on those areas that you want to be darker. We want to be getting it in all the recesses, and it doesn't have to be perfect here, we're not painting Space Marine armor, just make sure you avoid those sections that are going to be lighter. And as usual when you're using a contrast paint, if it is pooling in any areas, just get your brush, dry it off on a bit of paper towel, then just wick off any excess contrast paint there, and eventually you should end up with a decent enough finish and it should look pretty good. Then all you need to do is give it about half an hour to 45 minutes to dry and we should be good to move on to the next step. Next we're going to be painting any metal areas. I'm using Sakote Silver by Duncan's Two Thin Coats range, or you can use Lead Belcher by Games Workshop. What we're doing here is any metal areas on the bases, such as the manhole covers, and also if you're using the flight stands like I am, any of those metal areas in the centre, just put a couple of layers of metallics over that. Whichever paint you prefer, whatever colour you want to do them, you could paint them a different colour if you want, but I've just gone for a dark metal. The reason I'm using Sakote Silver rather than Lead Belcher, I just find these metallics are absolutely brilliant. They mix better and they go on a lot smoother than any other metallics that I've used, so that's just down to personal choice, but whatever colour you want, just thin it down, get a couple of coats on there and you should be good to move on to the next step. Next up, we're going to be shading the entire base. So for this, you're going to need contrast medium and Basilicarnum Grey, and we're going to mix this in a 2-to-1 ratio. So two parts contrast medium to one part Basilicarnum Grey. So what I've done is I've got my palette and I've just got the other end of an old brush, poor man's pipette, and I've measured out 6 drops of contrast medium. And in that, we're going to put 3 drops of Basilicarnum Grey and mix it up. Because I can't count as I was making this video, I actually ended up putting 4 drops of Basilicarnum Grey in. But as long as you're roughly 2-to-1, it doesn't really matter. We just don't want to overpower the bases because we are going to shade all of it, even the areas that we've already done with that pure Basilicarnum Grey earlier on, you know, for the road sections and the Aquilas. So the next thing to do is just get your brush, give it a good mix, make sure it's all thoroughly mixed together. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to slap it on all over the entire base. As I said, we're doing the whole thing, we're not just doing the lighter areas, we're going to put it over the entire base, including those areas that we've already done. The reason we've thinned it down a little bit is we don't want to absolutely saturate the color and darken them down, we just want to get it into all those recesses, because these Legions Imperialis bases are full of loads of tiny little details, tiny little cracks and stuff like that, because obviously they're meant to be made for epic scale miniatures. But we still want it to look good, even though they're probably going to get killed and taken off the tabletop really quickly. So as I said, just get a nice mix on there. As usual, if there's a bit of pooling, get your brush, dry it on a bit of paper towel and just wick off any excess. And again, I'm doing the exact same thing for the flying stands. And if you're painting any other bases as well for epics, like the Titan bases and stuff like that, you probably will need to mix up a little bit more of this. I found that 6 drops of the contrast medium and 3 drops of Basilicarnum Grey, that got me through about 15 of the normal sized infantry bases and probably a couple of these flight stands before I had to mix up some more. But to get it on there, as I said, make sure it's not pooling, wick off any excess, and then give it a good 45 minutes to an hour to dry. It might be a good idea now to go and have a break or a cup of tea, whatever it is you want to do, and then we'll move on to the next step. Now this next step is completely optional. What I did is I got some Agrax Earthshade and I've just run this selectively into some of the recesses on some of the bases. I didn't want to do it all over and we're not putting it all over the bases. What I've done is I've just painted it into some of the cracks and some of the smaller cracks where I thought dust and dirt might build up, and I've just rubbed off any excess with my finger. Alternatively, you could just put it all over the base if you wanted them to look really dirty, or if you wanted that extra warm weathering, or if you wanted like sand build up in various places. But just across various areas, various corners, I've just put that in there. Just try and do that extra little bit of weathering, just for a bit of variation more than anything. But as I said, this step is completely optional. You don't have to do it at all. Next, we're going to take some Null Oil or whatever black wash you prefer. And I suppose you could say this step is optional as well. What we're going to do is any metal areas on the bases, so on those flight stands we've got those metal parts, or any manhole covers on your bases, we're just going to run this into the recesses on there just to darken them down a little bit more. But the Basilicanum Grey and Contrast Medium mix that we did earlier did do a good job of shading these. It's just if you want to put that little bit of extra shade on there, that's what I've done with a little bit of Nuln Oil. But as I said, you don't have to do this step, but I think it just looks slightly better. By the way, if you've made any mistakes when you've been shading it, you can get some Cacharodon Grey by Toothing Coats or Administratum Grey. It's a great match for the washed bases that we've already done, so just tidy up any mistakes with those colours. Next up, we're going to do a little bit of stippling. Now, I've used Wizard Grey by Toothing Coats. The equivalent to that is Dawnstone by Games Workshop. So what you need is a stippling brush or an old dry brush, which is what I've got, and I've just cut the bristles flat. Then what we're doing here is we're just going to selectively add some colour variation. So dirt, wear, stoneware, stuff like that. So work off most of the paint onto a paper towel like you would do when you were dry brushing, but make sure there's enough on there. Test it on your thumbnail first or on your finger. Then just selectively stipple on some of the grey paint in areas where you think dirt might build up. You can do it however you want, really, randomly as you want. What I've done is concentrated on all, again, on all the cracks and crevices. You can see that on the flight stand that I'm doing here. So what I've tried to do is work the darker grey, although it's in some flat areas, I've tried to work it towards the cracks and crevices where dust and dirt would build up, because you would tend to get dirt and dust in those crevices and stuff like that. So that's what I've done, is I've just used it selectively. Be very, very careful. It's always easy to add more than it is to take away. So just make sure your brush is almost free of paint and just test it first. And then when I'd done the stippling, what I did then is I sort of did a reverse dry brushing. Rather than dry brush a lighter colour on, I'm just gently dusting that darker colour over the cracks and crevices to try and get that colour variation, that different tone, and try and have it blended across the base. It did work quite well, but as I said, when you're stippling, or when you're doing anything really where you're adding a colour to your base layers, just do it very, very carefully, as it's always easier to add more than it is to take away. So you can see with a gentle build up of the stippling and just dusting it slightly, it's giving it that nice weathered effect. Next, it's time to do some dry brushing. Now, I've used Trooper White by Toothing Coats, but you can use any colour you want. Pallid Witch Flesh, Screaming Skull, whatever you want for that lighter tone. I just found that with it being a lighter grey, Trooper White was the ideal colour. So as usual, working off any paint onto the paper towel and just testing it on my hand. And I've just gently gone round the edges of the bases. You'll notice I'm not doing a full back and forth motion like a heavy dry brush. I'm just being as light as I possibly can. I just really want to catch that edge and any raised areas on the bases, but I don't really want to overdo it, especially with the fact that I'm using a white colour. I did test it on my finger first, and I'm just being very gentle with it and making sure my brush is practically free of paint. As I said previously, when we were talking about the stippling, it's always easier to add more than it is to take away. So just do that, just work your way around the base with whatever the dry brush colour it is you want to use, just to bring out those raised areas, and you'll see that it does make a massive difference on the bases. Again, with these flight stands, just gently moving my way around the edges, trying to avoid the metal, and then again on some of the other bases as well, like the Titan bases, you'll see there are bigger raised areas, there's like stones that have been broken and there's raised stones and stuff like that, and it really does help catch and bring out that detail when you're dry brushing it. And finally, all we need to do is paint the rim of the base. So I've gone for Dungeon Stone Grey by Toothing Coats, or Mechanicus Standard Grey would be your equivalent. I just found it's a nice mid-tone. It's darker than the Aquila and the road sections, but it's not too dark like a black where it'd be too much of a contrast. So as usual, just thin your paint down, couple of coats around the edges of the base, and you're absolutely done and dusted. All that's left to do then, once it's dry, is just give it a coat of matte varnish, and there you go, you've got your finished city bases. It's a really easy scheme, it's nice and easy to do, and you don't have to just limit this to epic Legions Imperialis bases. This will work for any Warhammer 40,000 style city bases. If you're doing like a certain paint scheme for Space Marines or something like that, and you want a grey base, this would be absolutely ideal. And again, it could work for Age of Sigmar or Warhammer the Old World as well. If you want some stone style bases, this would definitely work for that as well. So anyway, that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it useful. Please let me know what you think in the comments. Leave me a comment. I always read them. I always look forward to reading and responding. And if you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up. Let me know you've enjoyed it. And if you didn't enjoy it, just leave me a comment, let me know why. Or if you think this paint scheme's rubbish, just leave me a comment, let me know what you didn't like about it, because that will always help me make better videos. But let me know what you think, and also let me know if you've pre-ordered the Old World as well. So we've just had the pre-order weekend for that. It was absolutely mental. But I managed to get hold of the Tomb Kings box. I'm going to be doing some videos on the Old World coming up very soon. So let me know in the comments also about that as well. Did you manage to get hold of the Old World? Are you interested in it? And again, as I said, let me know what you think of this base scheme as well. I hope you found it useful. I'm going to be doing some more painting videos on the channel as well. So make sure you like and subscribe. Stick around so you don't miss any future ones. But all that's left to say is thank you very much for watching, as always. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care.